Hello and welcome to Adonix Tech Tips. I am Richie and today we will be looking at how to unflag toolbox components. So typically when you open your assembly with a simple click for the new document, we can add a lot of components. But in the assemblies, what we do is we go to design library and we try to attach a lot of fasteners. So here we have in the design library so many components, so right click on it and create insert into assembly gives you the option to insert the fastener into the assembly. So once you add this in the feature manager tree, you could see that there is an icon which represents the design library. So this typically can be your custom made fastener. So here you can go to various options and create your own configuration of the tool set. Now once you save this, we can open the component and we can just save as the component on the desktop with your own some name, custom name. So this can be a custom fastener. Now many of us believe that once you save this component as some different name, it should be a custom created part, but that is not so. What I mean is, when you again use the same component in the assembly, so for example we are just inserting that fastener in this assembly, you can still see that there is the icon, the same icon which represents the toolbox. That means that this component is still linked to the toolbox. With this video, we are going to break the relation of this component with the toolbox. So how we can do is simply close SOLIDWORKS, go to the location, C program files, SOLIDWORKS Corp, SOLIDWORKS Toolbox, data utilities, and you find this small program that is SOLIDWORKS set document properties. Open with double click, set the properties to no. You can either add a single file or multiple files, or you can add directories. So we are just concentrating on this simple fastener as of now, and click on update status. So now you can see it has automatically determined that it is a part file. But if you have multiple components like parts and assemblies, you can go on clicking this type. So once you update the status, click close. Now let's open SOLIDWORKS once again and see whether the component which we had removed the document properties gets updated or not. So we are trying to open SOLIDWORKS here and let's create an assembly. So I'll close this Windows Explorer window. Okay, so we'll create an assembly again and we'll try to insert the same component. So again we'll point that to the custom fastener, click open and click OK. Now you can see that the link of the toolbox component has been broken and it is now just an ordinary part which you can obviously rename and use it in your assemblies. Now once you save this file and send it to someone else, the configuration of this toolbox won't change. It will be static. It will be what you see you have. So that is just a quick tip. For more such videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Adonis Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.